body, cause I don't wanna hurt nobody. Did it over, tasted and call me. Still got love. Hello, YouTube. If you're new here, I'm Marleya. If you're not, welcome back. Right now, I'm on my way to a showing. It is 6:56 in the morning. I said I'm going to get it done by any means necessary because I have hair at 9. And the person who contacted me, they said that they work really late in the evenings during the week. And that early weekends would be best for them. And I just wanted to make sure that I got them in. So I said, okay, let's schedule a showing for 7:30. They said it worked. So I'm up on my way to a showing. And I'm so sleepy. And then I have to do hair after this. But it feels good to be going on the showing, you know? Like, I'm appreciative of that, for sure. And hopefully I'll be able to find her something. She said that her timeline to move is 0 to 3 months, which is definitely possible for her to be able to find something in that time span. I'm pretty sure this is probably might be the last video. I might not record the house. I don't think I'm gonna record the house. But yeah, I just wanted to check in, get this vlog started. I think this is gonna be just like a weekend vlog because today is Saturday. And I don't really have too much to do today besides going to the hair store and doing hair this morning. Tomorrow I'm going to brunch with my friends. But yeah, I think that's it. Hey guys, I'm back from the showing. It went really good. I think they liked the house. Well, that's what they told me, at least. They liked the house, but I did say that I want to do a consultation with them just to figure out exactly what their criteria is and ask them questions about stuff that they might not have even thought of that they would want in the house themselves, just so we can get a better idea. I could show them more houses and things like that, because it was a young couple. I got them from Zillow. The way Zillow gives you leads is you'll buy a zip code, and then whenever somebody is in the market of that zip code, they can automatically call your phone like that. So she had literally just called me yesterday and wanted to see the house today. So typically when my Zillow leads, I don't have time to do a consultation first before they're expecting their first showing. So I just go ahead and I do that first complimentary showing. And then I'll do a consultation with them. I'll do our exclusive buyer agency contract. And then we really get the show going. So that's the stage I'm in with her. I just sent her over a message asking her when she would like to set up her consultation so we can continue to move forward. But overall, it went super good. They were impressed with the house. And I definitely see that we'll be able to do some work together for sure. But now I'm just sitting down here chilling. I'm about to do homework. I'm pretty sure I already told y'all that I'm in summer school. I'm doing 3 classes this summer. And at first, it was kind of like, before I started, it had me nervous because I would tell people that and they're like, oh my gosh, like that's going to be a lot. Summer's classes are double the work, da 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 da. But it's been like super light. Right now I'm doing homework for next week. So I've been knocking stuff out super fast. I already finished the homework for one of my classes next week, so now I'm moving on to the second. And my goal is to be able to get all my homework done this weekend. Today's Saturday. Get all my homework done this weekend so next week I can focus on getting even more ahead and doing like a lot of real estate work. It's so much stuff that I have to do. We kind of got a new system not too long ago, so I have to continue to learn the system and put my leads in a database and all that type of stuff, get it together. I go out of town in a few weeks. Speaking of that, I might be showing y'all me going shopping today. I'm not sure because I go out of town in a few weeks and I am not prepared for that at all. So I might be shopping today for that. But because I'm going out of town, I want to be able to have all my real estate organization stuff that I need to do done. I want to have my homework for that week done so I don't have to do homework at all the whole week that I'm going. Yeah, I got some stuff to get together. So stay tuned. Y'all, so I don't know if it's only me, but other college students, please please let me know, do y'all feel like it's excessive that we have to respond to two different people on these discussion boards? Because if we being completely honest, we hit them with like a, yeah, I agree, I disagree, add a little razzle-dazzle sentences behind it, and that's it. And I feel like professors know that. They definitely know that we do not care about discussing on these discussion boards. So I just feel like having to do two responses is just excessive. I don't even want to do my response. And I gotta respond to two other people? They know. Y'all, so I'm with my beautiful mother. We're about to pull up at Viva Fashion right now. I have no idea what I'm actually looking for because I don't have no clothes for the trip at all. We're going to LA and Vegas, so I need some cute stuff. Need some, it's about to be hot out here stuff. Probably some shorts. I only have biker shorts for real, for real. I don't have too many pair of shorts. And then really whatever else I find that I feel like I can use in my wardrobe, but we'll see when we get in here. In September, we're going to Beyonce, and y'all can't tell that this ain't giving Renaissance. It's giving Renaissance. Y'all, it's so hard shopping when you don't even know what you're looking for, because it'd be so much cute stuff. And like, that's not necessarily how I like to shop. I like to like have what I want my outfits to look like in mind, and then I can grab the pieces that match what I want and the vibe I'm going for. But I don't even have nothing I'm going for, so I really don't know what to look for because of that. Y'all, it is so hot out here. I don't know what the Midwest got going on, but like, it should be illegal for humans to be outside when it feel like this. Everything should close down like it's snowstorm and icy roads and stuff. We should not be outside. So y'all, we're at Five Guys. Y'all know I don't eat beef or any red meat, so I come here and I get the veggie sandwich, add cheese. I'm kind of sad. I don't know what just made me think of this. I love egg on my burgers. So I'm like, mama, do they got egg on the menu? They don't have no egg. I would have loved to add that to my veggie sandwich, but like just thinking about it, I've never had egg on my burger from here. So I don't know why I got my hopes up. They don't have it. But yeah, if y'all haven't tried the veggie sandwich from here, y'all should definitely try it. I know it sounds nasty. Like back when I was eating red meat, my auntie had told me about it, and I'm like, nah, I'm good with my burger. But now that I don't and I've tried it, it's fire, and I actually would prefer this over eating the beef anyway. Like, it's just good though. I'm hungry or if these peanuts just real good, but I think it's both. People always complain about Five Guys prices, but I don't think you can when they give you complimentary peanuts that are this good and a whole bunch of fries. They literally dump the fries in the bag, which I'm complaining about. So I just finished getting dressed and doing my hair to go to brunch with my friends. We're going to a place called Another Broken Egg, I believe. And it's like they have breakfast and brunch. I looked on the menu and y'all know I'm probably going to get waffles. They have some really good looking French toast too. But I just feel like every restaurant I go to, I have to try the waffles so I can always know who has the best waffles to me. Like, so that's most likely what I'm going to get. Or I'm going to order something that I want differently and then still get a waffle on the side. I don't know. We're going to see when we get there. Y'all, so we just pulled up to this restaurant. And we went through some obstacles to get here for real. Like, we had went to the... It's my bestie. We had went to the whole wrong location. And then we finally just pulled up here. And it's like, we trying to surprise my friend. So the communication with everything was just being so weird and all that. These my other friends. They look cute. it was just so weird, but we made it. Hopefully the food will be fire. Brunch restaurants really be the hardest places for me to figure out what I want to eat.
I've been looking.
Yeah, because
I'm trying not to get.
They got a honey lemon, blueberry French toast, chicken and waffles. Y'all know that's my stuff. Cinnamon roll French toast. Smoked salmon Benedict, crab cake Benedict, lobster omelet. Like, how am I supposed to make a choice?
It was cute, but I was like,
it's giving order the whole menu. Why they brought me waffles with no syrup, and then it's supposed to come with like this honey chipotle stuff, it ain't even drizzled on top. And then no, yeah, she asked me if I wanted the syrup. Yes, I want the syrup. Yes, I want my honey stuff. I ordered it.
What happened?
No,
it's
Kimon. She mad
because her lid off. It literally, I just watched it slide off. Like,
her whipped cream slid off. Perfect day for this because it is so hot out here. Like, it is so hot. She would have hit the video so bad, y'all. It's so hot out here. She cannot swim, and she just asked me if I would save her, and I just feel like that's unfair. I just feel like it's unfair because it's like, you know that you can't swim, so why would you even put me in a predicament to where I have to save you? Y'all, I done got my hair wet, but we doing swimming lessons. We finna try to teach them how to swim. I'm really scared to put y'all out here, so I'm risking it all so y'all can have a view. I don't know what y'all can see.
I don't think it'll get wet, because you can see how far the water is. Now, you know what? And they died.
What the fuck is that?
Y'all wanna... I already asked y'all that.
No, you said
when
we're
going towards the camera.
I said
on your feet.
Oh,
well, I'm hoping
me and her race on feet.
It don't matter. We're right here. Y'all only started from right here. If we're on foot, y'all only started from right here.
It's not that far.
I'm about to try to win, but it's hard enough.
All right, ready, set, go. Wait, hold on. Malia, you're going to stop me.
Well, who technically won the first one?
It was me.
Okay.
What's your name?
Ali, y'all better not beat you.
All right, now we have to walk under the water.
How I beat you?
I don't know. I can't even say.
Oh, like, okay.
Let me practice my swimming. It's actually not that hard. Yeah, it's really not.
I'm not going to the water.
She's going enough to die.
Is your towel okay? No.
Where is it?
Oh.
Okay, I need to see both of y'all.
We are.
Okay. Let's go.
From here?
Yep, let's go.
Are you ready?
You should. Don't jump.
Okay, don't jump.
She'd be jumping to get across.
Oh.
Okay.
Ready, set, go.
Yeah, okay.
Cream, or I just asked you if they wanted to go to the movies.
Yeah.
I don't know what we gonna end up doing, but I don't know.
No.
I don't know, but I probably won't be able to update y'all since my camera's finna die. But I don't know, we had fun. Today was really cool. I've been wanting to come swimming for a while, so I'm happy I was able to. Today was a really good day.